We've always been fascinated by the ability to grow back limbs. From the mythological Hydra to Marvel's Deadpool, it's clear that this ability would be useful. But fictional characters aren't the only ones who can regrow amputated limbs. Some animals, like sea stars, newts, and salamanders, actually have this ability. If these animals suddenly lose an arm or a leg, their bodies react by forming new tissue, nerves, and blood vessels, which then become a new, fully functional limb. Our bodies, on the other hand, respond to a wound or a cut by quickly patching it up with scar tissue. This prevents blood loss and bacterial infection. So why is there a difference in the way our bodies respond? And what do these animals have that we don't? Let's take a close look at salamanders to see what's going on. When they lose a limb, the regenerative response happens immediately. First, a layer of epithelial cells forms over the wound. This layer sends out signals to the surrounding tissues to recruit neighboring stem cells and stem-like cells. Together, these differentiate into cells needed to form a new limb. These cells collectively form a blastema, which grows outward. It first forms the boundaries of the new limb and then fills it in with muscle and bone. Signals passed between the cells tell them where they are relative to the entire limb, so they know where to stop. And in 30 to 90 days, the salamander has a new limb. The human body doesn't naturally form a blastema, and that's why we can't regrow limbs. But the cells forming the blastema are the same type as those found in a growing embryonic limb. This led some scientists to believe that the instructions for regeneration are just latent in our genes, waiting to be turned on. Unfortunately, recent evidence shows that animals with this ability acquired it later during their evolution, so we might not share it after all. So, unless you're signing up for the X-Men, you might be out of luck. For Scientific American's Instant Egghead, I'm Yasmin Tayag.